If a cow is not feeling well or their health is declining, the graph on the computer will tell us maybe before we can see it.
Initially, there was a few things it was saying were happening, and initially I was a little bit reluctant or didn't believe it. And then 24 hours later, sure as anything, what it said was going to happen happened, right? And so it was kind of a little bit eye-opening for us, and we realized the same thing that, hey, it's looking behind the scenes and it can find some things quicker than we can.
I'm Travis.
And I'm Jacqueline, and we're in Atwood, Ontario.
We're milking here with 85 cows with two VMS V310s, as well as the DeLaval Plus behavioral analysis system.
So we installed the DeLaval behavioral analysis program in June of last year. And the main reasons why we wanted to put it in is to look sort of on two avenues. The first is sort of the activity monitoring side, so to kind of help us figure out when is the optimal time for inseminating or breeding the cow. And the second reason was sort of fresh cow health, so the rumination and the feeding time. I look at that report many times throughout the day, and our goal kind of here is to be a little bit more proactive versus reactive. A day in the life of Jacqueline and I is not that different from when we had the parlor, so our kids still like to get up very, very early. And so we're up, 5 o'clock every morning, right, and ready to go to the barn.
So we come out, we check the calf barn first, just because that's closest to our house. We make sure all the calves have drank and that's clean. Then we walk past our calving pen to see if anyone's calving or needs help.
From there, we kind of make our way here and we check the computer reports. First couple of reports we check is our monitor board. We really like the monitor board here because it gives you like a one-page overview of everything that we think is important. From there, the next thing I check is our fresh cow report. So that's our rumination and our eating time. There's a little graph with every hour of the day, and it tells you whether or not she's done nothing, or if she's ruminated, or if she's eaten, and how much she has compared to her average, the pen average, and the whole group average for the last 24 hours and the last day. And so we're a big fan of looking at the deviations, right? Once we check that, we check our status list to see if there are any overdue cows, and then we determine if we're going to get them or not and what we need to do. It's really handy because you can go on your computer or on Companion, and you can select the cows you want to find for vaccinating, dry off, and inseminations, whatever it is. And then it shows basically like a map, and it's just like on Google Maps, right? It shows you all the dots in a picture of your barn. And so you know where those cows are. And then as we're doing the stalls, we kind of know those cows and bring them along with us so that they're at the robot to get milked or sorted once they're there. And then we deal with them.
Our finance background like allowed us to purchase this farm. We knew what we could do and what we couldn't do and how to do it and how to structure it. We are very number driven, so we want to have our expenses as low as possible and most profitable per kilo of quota.
When I would look at the bank and I would see the farmers who did well financially, they always focused on individual cow units, right? And so, and most of them, it was always based on repro, right? So the ones that had good repro, profitability usually followed. We were fortunate enough for, we'll say calendar year 2022, we were nominated by our vet clinic for the DCRC, so the Dairy Cattle Reproductive Council. They look at your preg rate, conception rate, culling rate, right? So do you just get rid of all the bottom enders or the trouble cows, or do you find a way to get them pregnant early? And then they rank you, and then so we were fortunate enough to be the platinum along with 5 other farms across North America. A few years ago, our preg rate was, we'll say, 20%. Behavioral analysis system has allowed us to breed those cows in the right window to kind of up our conception, right? And so right now we're running about a 38% preg rate, and so we're really happy with that. We use the progesterone drop kind of as an early warning sign that, hey, just so you know, this cow's probably in heat in the next couple days. But the BA, or the behavioral analysis system, what it does is it kind of helps us find out where in that drop is the best time to breed, because I'm actually a little bit surprised at the number of cows that, we'll say, don't follow the textbook. Some of them it will be as early as 12 hours after that drop. I would say the average is closer to probably 48 hours. But then some of them, it's even like 72 hours or a little bit beyond. Before, we used to manage populations and our herd in groups, and now with the VMS, the behavioral analysis system, and the progesterone side on the V310, lets us kind of put all those things together, look at it in we'll say one nice knee package in Delpro, and figure out what the best thing is that we can do for that cow to get her in calf pregnant. and our long-term goal is 2 kilos of fat across the board, and so we're still trying to get there, but I think these tools will help us achieve that.